Next up, we have the Man of Steel. No, not Superman, but the third and final Hoenn legendary titan, Registeel. Fans will of course remember it from the Gen 3 games, as well as Brandon packing one in the Battle Frontier arc of the anime, and Registeel playing a pivotal role in the Lucario and Mystery of Mew, where it followed its fellow Regis lead and had a bizarre cry that sounded like glitchy electronics you'd hear in house music. Anyways, today we'll be examining Registeel's impact on the competitive scene. So, how good was Registeel actually? And in this video, we'll be going over these competitive formats. Registeel was an odd case in the Gen 3 metagame. It wasn't really part of it, but it certainly had some valuable traits that the enterprising player could make use of. Its main draw was its massive bulk, which alongside Steel's Sandstorm immunity and numerous resistances to physical attacks, allowed it to repeatedly shrug off common choice banded moves like Rock Slide, Double Edge, Hidden Power Flying, Hidden Power Bug, and Meteor Mash. It could also shrug off a ton of dangerous special attacks, including Zapdos' Mighty Thunderbolt. However, Registeel had many significant deficiencies that prevented it from being as immovable as its appearance would suggest. It wasn't an effective physical wall due to its weakness to Earthquake, which every physical attacker carried with the exception of Heracross, who of course had something better in Fighting Stab. It was not an effective special wall as it lacked both recovery and the ability to dish out damage in return. Now having one of these flaws is okay, as Blissey isn't an offensive menace, while Snorlax and Regice are not renowned for their longevity. However, Blissey stays alive forever with Soft-Boiled and Wish, and Snorlax and Regice can leave lasting marks with their offense, which their teammates can capitalize on. Registeel gets worn down without doing any notable damage in return, meaning it has the worst of both worlds. To top it off, it was brutally weak to the Dugtrio packing these special attackers up and could not threaten it on the switch at all. There wasn't even hope for it going on the offensive with Explosion, like Snorlax and Regice. While it could have been a special tank that could boom without being overwhelmed quickly in the ever-present Sandstorm, its low attack stat was too much to overcome. Even with max attack, it couldn't two-hit KO a bulkless Jirachi, and it was still helpless against substitute Suicune. The severe Dugtrio weakness made Registeel even worse. With all that said, Registeel did have two legitimate uses in OU. The first was on niche stall teams, with knockoff Hariyama or Armaldo. By removing opposing team's leftovers, Registeel would become less passive, as its seismic tosses would now dish out lasting damage, and as such, it was able to better utilize its sand immunity, now being able to more realistically outlast opposing teams. It was also a terrific counter to the increasingly popular Earthquake-less mixed Metagross, which tended to leave gaps in defensive teams but couldn't dent Steel with Hidden Power Fire or even trade with Explosion. The second way to use Registeel was as a kind of surrogate Curse Lax on Magneton teams, which made sure there would be no Skarmory around. A curse or two with Registeel's already beefy defense meant the added Earthquake weakness was more than manageable, and the Sandstorm immunity made it a lot tougher to wear down, which further meant it wasn't forced to rest as easily, which is when it was vulnerable. For example, it only lost 6% per turn against Celebi's Leech Seed, and it wouldn't be nearly as pressured by Zapdos or Calm Mind Jirachi. Of course, being weak to Fire Blast was definitely not ideal, but Registeel usually posed quite a threat if it managed to grab a few curses, which was a realistic prospect. However, although these sets were decent, Registeel was still an incredibly niche Pokemon, with one of the team styles it fed on being niche itself, and was almost never seen at the higher echelons of OU play. And unfortunately, its lack of usage didn't let it be a part of UU, as it was absolutely unbreakable there, and as such was banned to Borderline, or BL. However, it did see use in Ubers. The Latty Twins reigned over the tier, and Registeel was an incredibly sturdy check to them, as well as Mewtwo outside of Sun, while also switching into powerful choice banded attacks like Deoxys Attack's Shadow Ball, Rayquaza's Hidden Power Flying, and Metagross's Meteor Mash. It was even able to turn the tables on its biggest would-be counters, Groudon and Kyogre, with Explosion. These were all amazing qualities in Ubers, and as such, Registeel was often called upon to handle the scariest Pokemon in the game. OU got a lot stronger and harder for Registeel to keep up with in Generation 4, as it didn't take kindly to the additions of Infernape, Heatran, and Lucario. The new Bronzong also outclassed it entirely. Thus, it dropped to UU, but this time it stayed there to make its name as one of the most defining, important Pokemon in the tier with its standard support set. It had a ton of useful options. It never went without Stealth Rock, of course, but from there the possibilities were endless. Thunder Wave was more common for its ability to spread paralysis against the common Fire Water Grass cores, but it could also use Toxic to threaten several key Pokemon that would otherwise come into Registeel without fear, some being ground types like Rhyperior, Torterra, and Donphan. And Toxic also helped Registeel be a genuine Milotic counter. This was especially effective because Steels besides opposing Registeel were rare, and Steel itself was excellent against poisons. As for offensive moves, Seismic Toss was the default for its ability to dish out consistent damage, and it was generally more useful than Iron Head. But one could go without either, as Status could handle the fire types, namely Morning Sun Arcanine, and Registeel's other offensive options had more utility that let it handle a wider amount of the tier, which was Registeel's job after all, not to dink away with weak stab or generally unthreatening 100 damage. Shadow Claw was the other most common offensive option, as it made Registeel the tier's best counter to substitute variants of Rotom and Mismagius, while greatly threatening the dangerous Alakazam and Mesprit. Ice Punch threatened Torterra, Altaria, Scyther, Swella, and Dugtrio, while still breaking Rotom and Mismagius' subs, and Explosion was always a good backup move to have, seeing as so little one-hit KO'd Registeel, even super effective moves. Its risky one-use nature usually wasn't Registeel's style, but like the Iron Man it resembled, it could sacrifice itself to save its team against a massive threat that it usually couldn't handle, such as Feraligatr, otherwise known as the Thanos of UU. Registeel's effectiveness using these moves came from its ability to check a vast portion of the metagame, including Tier King Venusaur. It was great as a part of sturdy balance teams that aimed to take their time and wear the opponent down, but it also fueled offensive teams that appreciated Steel giving them backbone against fast Pokemon like Swellow and Scyther. Registeel was always one of the most common Pokemon around because it was one of the best. It was ridiculously consistent on a game-to-game basis. It was such a big deal that it sometimes used Shed Shell just to escape Dugtrio, and even without Leftovers, which was its sole source of recovery, it was still excellent. It wasn't nearly as long-lasting, of course, but it could easily stop an offensive Milotic, a Sword Stance Leafeon, or a substitute Charge Beam Rotom, and then leave a dent in something else with Explosion. Registeel wasn't always relegated to support, though. It was also one of the most dangerous sweepers in the tier. Crowsteel, as the set of Curse, Iron Head, Rest, and Sleep Talk was called, turned weak Pokemon that stopped standard Steel like Spiritomb and Almastar into setup fodder. Outside of Haze Milotic, it was incredibly tough to beat without a special attacking fire type like Moltres, Blaziken, and Houndoom, none of which were famed for their longevity, a trait this Registeel packed in spades. Sleep Talk made it tough to prey on a resting Registeel, giving it the extra defense it needed to survive an earthquake or limiting the amount of counterplay the opponent could muster by throwing out boosted Iron Heads. Overall, when one thinks DPP UU, Registeel must be one of the first few Pokemon that come to mind. It plays a huge role in making the metagame what it is. Registeel also had a niche in the tier above OU once more, as it was able to withstand the Draco Meteor shower of Ubers quite well. And while it lacked the longevity and team support of Wish Jirachi or Bronzong's incredible Levitate, its superior overall bulk meant it was the best when it came to raw tanking ability. Registeel shrugged off all of Dialga, Palkia, Giratina Origin, Rayquaza, and Latios to set up Stealth Rock or spread Thunder Wave for its own heavy-hitting teammates. Steel was even able to take one absolutely immense hit, such as Rayquaza's Dragon Dance and Life Orb boosted Earthquake, or Choice Specs Palkia's Rain boosted Hydro Pump, letting it ruin them in return with Thunder Wave or Explosion, and letting its teammates reap the benefits. But unfortunately, Registeel's fighting weakness meant Darkrai ran over it with Focus Blast after a nasty plot, and given how terrifying Darkrai was, Jirachi and Bronzong were usually given the nod. However, if one needed sheer defensive prowess, Registeel was the Pokemon for the job. OU was far beyond Registeel's reach in Generation 5. Not only was it wholly unequipped to engage in Weather Wars, it was completely and utterly outclassed by the amazing new Ferrothorn, which incidentally took its job in Ubers as well, what with its Kyogre countering abilities and all. Anyway, Registeel found itself in UU once more, but this time around it was largely forgotten, owing in large part to its nemesis Bronzong also being UU and still significantly outclassing Steel. Bronzong's ground immunity and fighting neutrality were incredibly valuable traits that let it match up much better against the metagame at large. It was difficult for Registeel to be a consistent defensive stop when so much of the offense in the metagame revolved around not just fires like Victini and Darmanitan, which was a detriment to using Bronzong as well, but also fighting types like Heracross and Mien Shao, and ground types with Nidoqueen being an incredibly popular pick, as well as the ever-dangerous Rhyperior not far behind. Registeel was also worn down quickly by Roserade spikes, making it worse at dealing with Pokemon like Raikou and Azelf, unlike Bronzong. Yet another advantage the Bell had over Registeel. Unfortunately, Registeel was popular on the lower rungs of the UU ladder, where players don't know better, and unfortunately it saw enough not to drop to RU, where it likely would have been top tier. So Gen 5 was all kinds of cruel to the Steel Titan. Registeel's sole lifetime appearance in VGC came from Wolf Glick's 2013 team. Registeel itself was of course as niche as Pokemon get, but its titanic bulk and sand immunity let it fit on Wolf's Sandstall team that attempted to wall and wear down the whole metagame. In later years, Wolf renounced the team, saying it was too passive to actually be considered good, which is emblematic of Registeel itself. However, despite Registeel's and the team's shortcomings, Wolf piloted the team to a 25th place finish at Worlds, which is no mean feat. Generation 6 brought power creep in the form of Megas, knocking most Pokemon down a tier or two, and Registeel was no exception, as it found itself below UU for the first time, now residing in RU. Many Pokemon that heavily threatened the rest of the metagame, such as Yanmega and Shaymin, struggled to get past its incredible bulk and typing. However, it wasn't seen much in XY, as the metagame was incredibly offensive, packed with powerhouses like Moltres that Registeel was not good against. In Oras, Alolamola rose in usage and completely stuffed offense. Not only was the slower metagame good for Registeel's toxic stalling antics, Alolamola was an amazing partner for it, providing wish support and making it even harder to take down. This core dubbed Regimola was absurdly, ludicrously, and ridiculously difficult to break, especially with the Heelbeller and the excellent Defog Flygon in reserve to deal with otherwise troublesome status and hazards respectively. The core and its surrounding casts came to define not just stall teams, but the entire metagame. It was so common and so overbearing that players ran otherwise ridiculous sets like Block Venusaur and Slowking just to beat them. But part of the beauty of Regimola was that it could usually adapt. For example, Charge Beam Rest Magneton destroyed standard Registeel, but once Registeel slapped on Earthquake, it was no longer a problem. Bulk Up Braviary could set up 101 HP substitutes that survived Seismic Toss, so it could safely set up without being toxic. But Registeel started running Thunderbolt to break the sub, and that was that. Several of the tier's bans helped Registeel too. It appreciated the removal of Dugtrio, one of its few threats, and Mega Steelix's departure meant that Registeel's only Steel-type Stealth Rock competition was the Pursuit-weak Bronzong. Overall, Registeel was one of Gen 6 RU's most defining Pokemon, heavily responsible for the tier's defensive nature. Anyone who's ever played the tier can attest to how infuriatingly immortal it seems, with its best friend Alolamola effortlessly passing it wishes. Registeel was an incredible RU Pokemon in Generation 7 once again. Its defensive presence could not be overstated, as from the onset of the tier, it established itself as one of the metagame's premier Pokemon and an immensely important part of any team it was on's defensive integrity. As usual, it easily set up Stealth Rock against and checked several of the tier's most dangerous Pokemon, such as Mega Abomasnow, Gardevoir, and the new Boom Burst Swellow, while also waltzing in on several common defensive Pokemon used to thwart offense themselves, such as Diancie and Cresselia. This made Steel a synergistic choice for both defense and offense teams alike. Registeel also gave its team a big fat resist to the stabs of many common dangerous choice users, Tyrantrum and Escavalier, which was key in holding off their assault. With Toxic and Protect, it spread passive damage like nobody's business, making defensive Pokemon like Mandibuzz and Noivern think twice about coming in to try and defog, while ensuring that strong attackers like Rhyperior and Beware didn't switch in for free either. Protect also meant wearing Registeel down with repeat and neutral attacks was exceptionally difficult so long as it didn't take a knockoff. When Donphan rose in popularity to easily spin against it, Registeel started adding speed investment, so once it got the Toxic off on Donphan, it could play the longer game and have the edge when the chips were down by potentially finishing Donphan off with Seismic Toss and thus being able to keep its Stealth Rock up. Donphan then crept speed right back, and so it continued. Getting rid of Registeel's rocks was difficult with the other anti-hazard options in the tier, so this matchup was incredibly important and could sway the outcome of the battle. Something as slow as Registeel running a significant amount of speed EVs as an effective anti-Registeel measure spoke to its enormous effect on the metagame, which again cannot be emphasized enough. It was truly a titan of the tier. And that's it. So how good was Registeel actually? Well, it never had OU glory and was too good for lower tiers when it debuted. But starting in the following generation, it became an iconic defensive pillar in the lower tiers. With the exception of Gen 5, it easily set up Stealth Rock and thwarted tons of notable threats to the point where the metagame it was in had to go out of their way to account for it. It wasn't a flashy Pokemon, but Steel typing and high bulk is one of the best combinations of Pokemon. And with it, Registeel consistently got the job done like nothing else. Thanks for watching, everyone. And as always, if you like the video and you want to see more, be sure to subscribe to False Swipe Gaming for our weekly Pokemon content. And in the comments, I want to know, what do you think about competitive Registeel? How would you make it so that it could actually be useful in OU? Or do you like it the way it is currently? Whatever it is, let me know in the comments. Also, thank you so much to our patrons for continued support of our videos, and thank you to everyone else watching as well. and follow my crew on these social media platforms. And that's all I got. See you next time, everyone.